India's obsession over Western culture has been increasing at full speed, especially in the past two decades. We had thousands of cafes in India, but none of them got the grand welcome as much as Starbucks did. Men of this generation don't even know how to wear a vesti. How many of our kids can read and write in our native language? When Justin Bieber performed in India, the crowd was uncontrollable. But our classical singers and dancers perform at empty halls. They get no audience even if the ticket is free. And the obsession over fasting is a never-ending story. In Indian cinema, people of low class are always portrayed as dark-skinned. And people of high class are always fast-skinned. And we still study that Vasco da Gama discovered India. It's a shame for us. For a Portuguese student, it's reasonable enough to say that Vasco da Gama discovered India. Because they didn't know where India was. But us, Indians, should be saying Vasco da Gama came to India in 1498. But still, after 75 years of independence, we are still saying that Vasco da Gama discovered India. Even recently, when actor Madhavan said Panjangam has been used in rocket science, internet was full of trolls, as if anything that is Indian cannot be right. But to the same incident, ISRO scientist Milesamy responded that Panjangam is very much for rocket science. The only thing that has to be corrected is Panjangam is not something that was calculated 1,000 years ago. It is something that has to be calculated every year. But this response never went viral. Why is India obsessed with Western culture? Why are Indians looking down on everything that is Indian? Is this a calculated move or just a development process that happens over a period of time? If this is a process of modernization, it doesn't have to copy everything that is Western. Remember, being Western and modern are two different things. I would say this inferiority complex of Indians was a well-calculated move made by Britishers 200 years ago. The education system we are following today was made by a man who thought Indian knowledge and language are completely worthless. For instance, he said of Indian literature, a single shelf of good European library was worth the whole native literature of India and Arabia. Yes, he's Thomas Babington Macaulay, the man who designed our Indian education system, the man who was completely blind towards the richness of Indian heritage, the man who believed that the Western science is far superior to Indian knowledge. Macaulay wanted the government to spend money only on importing Western education and advocated to shut out all the educational institutions of Indian culture. He wanted to create a pool of Indians who'd be able to serve the Britishers and be loyal to them. In his own words, he said, "The purpose of English education is to create a class of persons, Indian in blood and color, but English in taste, in opinion, in morals, and in intellect." And today, he is quite successful at what he wanted. That's why we are familiar with Einstein, not with Aryabhatta, the Indian sage who invented zero 1500 years ago and propounded that the earth is round, rotates on its own axis and revolves around the sun, which is called the heliocentric theory in Western culture. It was an Indian sage named Sushruta taught plastic surgery and cataract surgery to the world around 2800 years ago. A statue of Sage Sushruta is installed in the Australian College of Surgeons, Melbourne. But we Indians haven't even heard about him. Angkor Wat, the largest religious building on this planet, was built by a Tamil king named Suryavarma. How many of you read even a single line about this in your school days? Forget about you. I, being an history graduate, didn't read a single line about this. We were busy learning about the Great Wall of China and the Pyramid of Egypt. There's a saying in history. People without the knowledge of their history, origin and culture are like trees without roots. If we have no pride in who we are, we would be half-baked Britishers in the next 50 years.